Hello everyone, I am Saveri and I am here with a very interesting concept, that is your consumer surplus and your producer surplus. So consumer surplus and producer surplus are very easy to understand concept, but I have seen so many of you guys making a mistake that your consumer surplus is actually your savings out of your market and your producer surplus is actually your profit. That is wrong, and let's understand how. So let's understand consumer surplus first. So consumer surplus is the reward that you get out of your market just by consuming some commodity of a particular good. So for example, you want to buy a pen and you think that the cost of that pen is 10 rupees. And let's say you go to the market and then you realize that the cost of that particular pen was only 8 rupees. Now you have these 2 rupees extra with yourself, and this is actually your consumer surplus. So this is different from your savings, as savings is a macroeconomics concept and you need to know the marginal propensity to save, which is a macroeconomic trend, and you need to know both of these things to understand the concept of saving. And the consumer surplus is actually the savings out of just one commodity and keeping everything constant. And it is so strong of an assumption that we actually introduced a new term, that is ceteris paribus, that means keeping everything else constant. So this does not make your savings rate, it is just the consumer surplus that is a reward. Next is your producer surplus. Now producer surplus is different from your profit. Let's understand how. So taking the example of this pen seller again. So the seller actually is selling at 8 rupees and the cost of that one particular pen was 7 rupees. Now he makes a producer surplus of 1 rupee in this transaction. So that is your producer surplus, and he is actually considering your total cost and your variable cost. Let's understand profit again. So profit is actually total cost minus total revenue minus your total cost. Now this is a economics term, and since we are economists, we will understand the difference in detail. So your profits actually considers total cost, which is a summation of your total variable cost and your total fixed cost. Now producer surplus is total revenue minus your variable cost, just the variable cost. How it is different from the fixed cost, let's understand from that seller example again. So seller actually pays a fixed cost of a rent on that particular shop that he owns. So that rent is actually a fixed cost which he considers while considering his profits at the end of the month or end of the year. That is his profits, and your variable costs are like electricity bills or the water bill. These are your variable costs which changes every single month. So this is a difference between your producer surplus and your profits. So I hope this will make your life a little bit easy when you are understanding the concepts like monopoly, where the producer actually tries to consume all the consumer surplus such that the consumer surplus actually becomes zero if he knows what is the exact demand on the exact prices, which is meant by your perfect price discrimination. So all these concepts, the bargain between your consumer and your producer, actually make the base of your microeconomics. And I hope this video will help you understand microeconomics a little better. So thank you.